don't feel sorry for David. He had a mighty God on his side. Don't feel sorry for David. Goliath couldn't win if he tried. If you're going to sympathize, don't look at David's size. Goliath was a midget if you're looking through God's eyes. So don't feel sorry for David. He had a mighty God on his side. I've got a song to sing about David and his sling. The armor of the king to David didn't mean a thing. You see, his sling was tried and true. He knew what God could do. He killed a bear and lion too. Surely God would see him through. Don't feel sorry for David. He had a mighty God on his side. Don't feel sorry for David. Goliath couldn't win if he tried. If you're going to sympathize, don't look at David's size. Goliath was a midget if you're looking through God's eyes. Don't feel sorry for David. He had a mighty God on his side. The battle David fought may be just like the one you've got. The Lord brought David through and he can do the same for you. Satan's filled with pride, to his followers he's lied. He never will confide that he's on the losing side. So don't feel sorry for David. He had a mighty God on his side. Don't feel sorry for David. Goliath couldn't win if he tried. If you're going to sympathize, don't look at David's size. Goliath was a midget if you're looking through God's eyes. So don't feel sorry for David. He had a mighty God on his side. If you're gonna sympathize, don't look at David's size. Goliath was a midget if you're looking through God's eyes. So don't feel sorry for David. He had a mighty God on his side. He had a mighty God on his side. He had a mighty God on his side. Don't feel sorry for David. He had a mighty God on his side. We have that familiar account found in 1 Samuel chapter 17. Verses 49 and 50, where it says, "And David put his hand in his bag and took thence a stone." So he had gathered five stones, and he took out one stone and slung it and smote the Philistine in his forehead, that the stone sunk into his forehead, and he fell upon his face to the earth. So David prevailed over the Philistine with a sling and with a stone, and smote the Philistine and slew him, but there was no sword in the hand of David. And that's because, you see, Saul had offered his armor, but he had not proved them, and he couldn't go with them. Instead, he took what God had used in his life already. He'd killed a bear and a lion while watching sheep. You know how shepherds are. They've got to protect the flock. And so young David, just a teenage boy, had killed a bear, killed a lion, and he had some experience at this, but God propelled that stone to kill the champion of the Philistines and give God's people the victory through David, young David. Don't feel sorry for him. And today you're facing some giants, some Goliaths in your life as well. I don't know in what area, but you can apply it just about across the board. And don't feel sorry for yourself and your situation. Compared to God, whatever it is you're facing is just so small, so tiny. And God's got it. God's got it covered. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the victory that we have through the Lord Jesus Christ. Help us not to feel sorry for ourselves and to realize that you're the one who's going to give us the ultimate victory over everything that we face as we are in your will and yielded to you. With heads bowed and eyes closed, do you know Jesus Christ is your Savior today? For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Would you pray right now from your heart to God? Pray something like this. Dear God, I admit that I'm a sinner. I deserve to pay for my sins. I believe Jesus died to save me, and right now I receive the Lord Jesus Christ into my heart as my personal Savior. Please take away my sins and take me to heaven when I die. Did you pray that prayer? Oh, I hope you did. And if you did, let us know, and we'd be glad to help you out in your Christian growth and life. Right now, soul winners, keep after it. Keep going after the lost. Keep winning souls. That's the answer. That's the key. And everyone out there that's challenged, remember God is bigger than your challenge, bigger than your Goliath. Lord, I thank you that you're going to defeat the giants in our life today as we claim that truth in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. All right, sing it with me. Don't feel sorry for David. He had a mighty God on his side. Don't feel sorry for David. Goliath couldn't win if he tried. If you're gonna sympathize, don't look at David's size. Goliath was a midget if you're looking through God's eyes. So don't feel sorry for David. He had a mighty God on his side. God bless you today.
You're listening to From the Shepherd to the Sheep Daily Devotionals. This is a ministry of Central Baptist Church in Woodbridge, Virginia. If you would like to learn more about our ministries, you can find us online at cbcwoodbridge.org. You will also find many other helpful resources there, including preaching, devotionals, and songs. We thank you for listening to this devotional, From the Shepherd to the Sheep.